Philippine military scrambling to retrieve the data recorder of its C-130 plane that crashed in Sulu Sunday. The death toll from that crash has risen to 50, of which 47 are soldiers and 3 are civilians. 49 others were hurt. The plane crashed while attempting to land at an airport in Jolo, Sulu. Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana has ordered a full probe into the incident, considered one of the country's worst involving a military aircraft.
We can say na nagpapatuloy pa rin yung ating ginagawa, but this time this is going to be retrieval operations. We are looking for the flight data recorder for us to be able to identify and determine with technical specifications kung ano ang nangyari dito sa pag-crash na ito ng ating C-130 aircraft. And ang meron tayong information was that tama naman yung kanyang speed ng paglapag. The aircraft landed, the gears landed on the right spot. Subalit for unknown reason, ay nag-overshoot ito sa runway. Mm-hmm. It's too early for us to speak about foul play. Ganun din yung mga tanong sa akin about possible attack on the aircraft. So far, wala tayong nakikitang ganyan.
The U.S. offers condolences to the Philippines following the deadly plane crash. U.S. National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan says Washington is ready to provide all appropriate support to Manila's response effort. The ill-fated C-130 plane was sold by the U.S. to the Philippines just this January. Well, the remains of the military troops who died in the Sulu plane crash being brought to Zamboanga. Our correspondent Queenie Casimiro now joins us with the details. Queenie, what else can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, the bodies of soldiers killed in yesterday's C-130 mishap has been brought to the different funeral homes in Zamboanga City. This morning, we witnessed the arrival of 11 cadavers inside caskets and body bags here at Villa Funeral Home. 6 more are expected to arrive here. In another more, 20 cadavers of plain soldiers were brought since last night. In the last update we got from the Joint Task Force Sulu as of 10 p.m. Sunday night, 47 soldiers were killed while 49 were wounded in the tragedy. All of those wounded have been evacuated to Zamboanga City as of 9 a.m. today. A source of ABS-CBN told us that 38 of those killed are identified due to the injuries that they sustained following the crash. We are also expecting the arrival of the TNT SOCO team to get DNA samples from the unidentified bodies. It is quite difficult to get information as of now, since according to Western Mindanao Command, only the GHQ will release any updates or information related to the C-130 plane crash. For ANC, Queenie Casimiro, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Queenie Casimiro, there joining us on the line. Take care, Queenie, and you keep safe. Moving on, the lower house not keen on conducting a probe into the Sulu crash for now. Rufy Biazon, senior vice chairman of the House Committee on Defense and Security, says they will let the Defense Department and the armed forces conduct their investigations first before making any move. But he says he finds it disturbing that the newly purchased plane would be involved in such a catastrophe.
Moving forward, of course, we would want to know the cause of this this crash. Whatever the results of the investigations are, we hope that we can also look into how to prevent it in future time. Recently, we acquired these aircraft, and so we're using them again as transport. So it's really quite disturbing that this has happened because it's been a long time since we've seen such an accident with mass casualties.